Traditional Wi-Fi networks using a standalone router can leave your home with dead spots and other areas where you don't get a strong Wi-Fi signal. Over the years, there have been multiple solutions to help address this problem, namely Wi-Fi extenders and wireless access points. But the truth be told, the best solution is the latest one to be developed. What I'm talking about here are mesh Wi-Fi networks. In this episode, we're going to be talking about what mesh Wi-Fi networks are, how they work, and why they are a great choice for the next upgrade of your home network. So what is mesh Wi-Fi? Well, the biggest difference is, instead of having one standalone router broadcasting Wi-Fi signal in your home, what you have is you have multiple mesh nodes all broadcasting Wi-Fi signal throughout your home. The big benefit here, obviously, is you don't have any Wi-Fi dead spots, because all of these nodes are broadcasting the same Wi-Fi network throughout your home. Now keep in mind, similar to a standalone router, these nodes still broadcast different Wi-Fi networks, as in you'll still have a 2.4G and a 5G Wi-Fi network, but all of these devices will be broadcasting the same one, and it doesn't matter if your device is connected to this mesh node, this mesh node, the performance is the same regardless of the node you're connected to. In essence, a mesh Wi-Fi network is similar to having a standalone router with multiple Wi-Fi extenders, except it's totally not the same thing because these mesh nodes provide significant performance benefits when compared to Wi-Fi extenders. To illustrate exactly what I'm talking about, let's take a look at an example. Okay, to walk through an example, first let's take a look at a home network where we're using Wi-Fi extenders. If we just have our standalone router and modem here in the corner, you have a Wi-Fi signal that's broadcast from that one standalone router. And as you can see, that Wi-Fi coverage doesn't cover your entire home, and that's how you get a dead zone. So what is the logical thing to do here is you implement a Wi-Fi extender. So here in another room, we implement a Wi-Fi extender. It provides us with enough Wi-Fi coverage that all of the square footage of our home is covered and we don't have any dead spots. So now let's look at that same example here with a mesh Wi-Fi network. Here we have one mesh node in place. As you can see, similar to your standalone router, it's broadcasting a Wi-Fi signal, but it still leaves a dead spot in your home. So what do? You implement a second mesh node in your home network. You now have enough coverage with your Wi-Fi signal to cover your entire home. So looking at these two examples to this point, it seems like they're pretty much the same, right? Well, actually, it couldn't be further from the truth. And that's because of the difference between how these mesh nodes communicate with each other compared to how a Wi-Fi extender and a standalone router communicate with each other. We'll start with your standalone router example first. What's happening here when your Wi-Fi extender and your standalone router are talking to each other? Is they're using the same Wi-Fi channel that all of your devices do when they're trying to communicate with your router or your extender. What this leads to is a degradation in performance, especially with your devices that are connecting to your Wi-Fi extender. With Wi-Fi extenders, you're lucky to get half of the bandwidth that your standalone router provides. So very quickly, you'll find out that you're not getting as good a performance if you're using a Wi-Fi extender. Conversely, when your mesh nodes are communicating with each other, they're communicating on a totally separate Wi-Fi channel that your devices use when they're communicating with your nodes. Because these nodes are communicating on a totally separate channel, you have no issues. It's always clear communication, no one's talking over each other, and you don't see any performance degradation. If you're connecting to this node or this node, the performance is all the same. Jumping back to the standalone router example, another downside of using a Wi-Fi extender is that many of these extenders have a different Wi-Fi network name and password than your standalone router does. So if you're in this room and you're connected to the standalone router, no problem, you know what the Wi-Fi network and password is. But then if you move to this room, you need a stronger Wi-Fi signal and you connect to the extender, you're connecting to a different Wi-Fi network, and it's not really a seamless transition from one Wi-Fi network to the other. Jumping back to the mesh Wi-Fi example, we don't have the same problems that the Wi-Fi extender presents, and that's because these nodes are all broadcasting the same Wi-Fi networks with the same passwords. This makes it really easy for you to move from one room to another. Your device will change the mesh node it's connected to, but this will all happen automatically and you won't have to do anything. All right, let's jump back to this Wi-Fi extender solution for another example. Let's say we have good Wi-Fi coverage in our home, but we wanna put an addition on the home. We're adding another room here, and what you find out is you can't use a Wi-Fi extender to extend the Wi-Fi signal to this room. The reason for this is that this Wi-Fi extender is too far away from the standalone router to take its Wi-Fi signal and rebroadcast it. The next logical solution would be to take the Wi-Fi network that's being broadcast from your Wi-Fi extender and just rebroadcast that with another extender. The issue here is that you have very significant performance degradation if you daisy chain these Wi-Fi extenders together, and it's really not a recommended solution. And that's because with each Wi-Fi extender, you have significant loss in performance. Just remember, with connecting to this Wi-Fi extender, we're getting about half the bandwidth that this standalone router provides, and that's because of all this communication that's happening on the same Wi-Fi channels that we talked about earlier. So if we were to go and daisy chain another Wi-Fi extender, you'd be getting half of the standalone router's performance here, and then half of that by daisy chaining another extender. You wouldn't get good internet performance, and that's why it's not a recommended solution. With a mesh Wi-Fi network, this is not an issue. We can add another room to our home, and you can get this Wi-Fi signal expanded to the new room without any issues. And that's because you can daisy chain these mesh nodes together. This mesh node can talk to this mesh node, which can talk to the main source node in your home. A little disclaimer is this might not be the case with all of the mesh Wi-Fi networks that are available. I just know that with my TP-Link BE5000, which is a newer mesh node, I can do this. I can daisy chain these nodes together, but this is a significant benefit over a Wi-Fi extender. When it comes to the benefits of mesh Wi-Fi networks, we've talked about a lot of them at this point, but there's a few that I want to hammer home. The first is that these solutions are so flexible. For example, you can buy one mesh Wi-Fi node and replace your standalone router, and then see what kind of performance it gives you. If you still have Wi-Fi dead spots in your home, it makes it so easy. You just buy another mesh device, see if that covers all your dead spots, and so on and so forth. You can add mesh nodes as you need them. If you move to a bigger home or you have a lot of devices that you want to provide a strong Wi-Fi signal for, you can scale up your mesh Wi-Fi network as you see fit. In addition, it's really easy to add another node to your mesh Wi-Fi network. I'll make another video that details how to do this, but even non-technical people can do it really easily, so it's nothing to worry about. These solutions are obviously perfect for people with large homes or people that live on a lot of levels, just because you can buy as many devices as you need to get a good Wi-Fi signal. But keep in mind, it's also good for people with a smaller footprint as well. You only need to get one mesh Wi-Fi device, and you know that you can add to it if you ever move to a bigger property or a bigger home. Another thing I love about mesh Wi-Fi networks is the simplicity of managing the Wi-Fi networks themselves. All of the devices, they broadcast the same Wi-Fi network with the same password, and your devices automatically connect to the node that it has the strongest Wi-Fi signal with. It really doesn't get any easier than that. All right, so we've talked about the good, but what are the downsides of mesh Wi-Fi networks? Well, honestly, there aren't that many. For some mesh Wi-Fi networks, they can be pretty expensive, but I found that with these TP-Link Deco BE5000 devices, one node costs about $100. For many of you, that might even be cheaper than your standalone router. If you're curious in checking out these devices or you'd like to buy one, I'll include a link in the description below. And check it out. You might even see a little bit of a discount code down there. So if you go and buy one of these devices, you'll save even more money. One thing I want to caution here, and this might be a legitimate downside of mesh Wi-Fi networks, is that many people go and they buy more nodes than they actually need to support their home. So if you go and you buy a 3-pack of nodes, but you only really need one or two, you'll be spending more money than you actually need to. And many times you'll see an upsell where you'll get a 3-pack at a discounted price, But if you don't need that additional node, you're just spending additional money that you really don't need to. And the last con that I'll talk about is one we talked about in the previous example. But if you're daisy chaining a lot of these devices together, you will likely begin to notice performance degradation when you're connected to that node that's last in the chain. With that said, if you have two or three mesh nodes daisy chained together, you're probably not going to notice a performance degradation, but just keep in mind that if you start to string a lot of these devices together, it will have an impact on your performance. So who should buy a mesh Wi-Fi solution? Well, quite honestly, I think everybody should. Even if you're buying one mesh Wi-Fi node to replace the standalone router in your home, you're opening the door and giving yourself the flexibility that if your internet needs change or you move to a bigger home, you could just add an additional node to your mesh network and you won't have any other issues. I recently made the switch to a mesh Wi-Fi network, and honestly, at this point, I don't think I'll ever go back. I'd love to see in the comments section if you're currently using a mesh Wi-Fi network or if you decided to go ahead and buy one of these BE5000 nodes, because I'd love to see what your experience is to this point. As always, thanks for checking out this episode from Network from Home, and we'll catch you on the next one.